Good afternoon. Welcome to our fourth Sunday of Advent, the day before Christmas. We thank you for being here, and we ask you at this time, please, to silence your cell phones. And just as a reminder of the Mass schedule upcoming, because we'll see you again, right? Christmas Eve is tomorrow, so we have a 5 p.m. Mass with a 4:30 prelude. We have a 7:30 Mass, which is bilingual. We have the midnight Mass with an 11:30 special music prelude. And then on Christmas Day, we have 10:30 Mass. So, Merry Christmas, and we hope to see you there. Please stand and join in our opening song, which is found in the Spirit and Song at number 140. Number 140, Emmanuel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are in the presence of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our God, our Good Shepherd, who leads us to our Heavenly Father with the light of the Holy Spirit. And to prepare ourselves to celebrate God's presence, let us call to mind our sins.
I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christ eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am, living in a house of cedar, while the ark of the Lord dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go. Do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night, the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go, tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people, Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all of your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
How I feel like singing, announcing to the world your constant faithful love, O Lord. You have have shown the greatness of your love. By covenant you chose us as your own until the end of time. Forever I will sing the goodness of the splendor, the reason for our strength, the cause of all our hopes and dreams. Only by your love do we exist, only by your choice glorified. I see you, O Lord our God. The goodness of the Lord. I have found my servant David, and with my holy oil anointed him that he be strong. He shall know my faithful hand is there. He shall say of me, you are my Father, my Savior God, my Rock. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings, and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Is at hand. Repent and believe in the good news.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. And he will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and that this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There was a great promise in today's first reading in the book of Samuel. "I will give you a powerful king, and he will conquer every nation around you, Israel. And David, I will build a house for you forever." Beautiful promise. Later in the book of Isaiah, the Lord says, "I will give you a baby. You will call him Emmanuel." A baby? A baby is going to defend us from the other nations? A baby is a solution for all our problems, Lord? Questions, many questions. A few months ago, I heard a young man, a Jewish man, saying in television, "I don't believe that Jesus is God because at the beginning of the last and actual war, I don't believe in Jesus Christ because he is not God. How can he be our God? Where is Jesus now?" We expect a Messiah, a powerful Messiah, but not Jesus Christ. Many people still believe that. Even John the Baptist had his questions. That Jesus is too compassionate. And he sent his people to ask Jesus, "Are you the one who is going to come?" Because we are expecting a Messiah that brings the wrath of God upon sinners. And you, Jesus, you forgive everyone. Are you the one who is going to come? Questions. Many questions. I hope that tomorrow we can make this spiritual exercise. Let us stand in front of the nativity set at home or wherever you sit, because there are many around, even in the stores. Stand in front of the nativity set and ask him, where are you from, Jesus? Who are you, Jesus? Because he himself asked his disciples, who do you say that I am? Who do you say that I am? Because even today many people don't believe in Jesus Christ. Practically, don't believe in Jesus Christ. Many people have some knowledge, intellectual knowledge about Jesus Christ. But when it comes to practice, they don't believe. Let the Lord ask you, who do you say that I am? Ask him, who are you? Where are you from? Since you, Jesus, are trying to move my heart, my soul, my decisions, since you, Jesus, died for me, since you, Jesus, are at the center of every decision I make in my life, tell me, who are you? Where are you from? And the Gospels give us many answers. Ask St. Luke, ask St. Matthew. They will give you a long genealogy, a long list of names. He comes from there. From that blood, from that family. Ask John in his gospel, beautiful answer. In the beginning, he was with God. He came to dwell among us. He made his tent among us. He is the Word of God. From the beginning. They can give us some answers. But the Lord says, but you, what do you say that I am? We can give him many answers. But the second reading today asks us to proclaim our faith, our faith, to believe with all our heart and soul and mind that he is the Son of God. He is the Son of God. But we need faith, not only intellectual knowledge, because that knowledge doesn't help us when we make ugly decisions or good decisions. We can make good decisions, the best decisions, but we believe that it is my decision, it is my strength, it is my courage, it is my talent. No, it is coming from God. It's a calling from God. Stand in front of the nativity set and ask him, who are you? And if you have this dialogue with him, he likes dialogues. There is one very important, very powerful in the Gospel of John, chapter 18, 19, with Pilate. Are you a king? Yes, I am a king. You said so. And my kingdom is not from this world. My kingdom is not what you believe. When you believe That promise in the first reading, the powerful king, my kingdom is not like that. My kingdom is not from this world. Where are you from? I was born to testify to the truth, said Jesus Christ. Tomorrow we will celebrate his birth. And he says, I was born to testify to the truth. And the truth will set you free. And many of us have many problems today because we don't want to accept that truth. And we don't recognize the truth. It is a person. And everything he said, everything he did, is the truth. Why are we celebrating his birth? What is the purpose of this? He says, I was born to testify to the truth. Let us stand in front of the nativity set. Let us ask him, what is the truth? And don't be afraid to ask him, what is the truth? It is himself, but maybe you will go beyond that affirmation and you will realize the truth is that that one handsome man is not my husband. That pretty young woman is not my wife. That money doesn't belong to me. The truth will set you free. I was born to testify to the truth. Beautiful. May the Lord give us the grace to celebrate him tomorrow in a new way. And then to continue celebrating his presence, his love, for the rest of our lives. For the rest of our lives. Thank you, it's the end, yeah. Please stand. Let us proclaim our creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death, was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. In his kingdom we have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Let the clouds rain down the just one. Let the earth be opened and bring forth a Savior who will hear the needs we place before him.
For the church,
who daily endeavors to make known God's kingdom, that determination and joy mark her work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the peoples of the world, that cooperation between nations be a sign that God's home encompasses all the earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For pregnant women, and for those who assist them in giving life, that they know the joy of the birth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faith community, may we create a home for God's people where all are welcome. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, may they continue to exemplify for us how God's kingdom lasts forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And now we bow our heads and remember the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Emmanuel, God with us, help us make a world where all will have a voice and a place at the table of life. May we be renewed by your coming and heed your calling to build a more just world. May no one go hungry, be lonely, or deprived of the promised salvation of Christmas, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
The song for the presentation and preparation and presentation of gifts is in Gather at number 782, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For the praise and glory of his name,
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Brigid, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Father, listen gracefully to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Father, today we pray for the health of Ezra Rincon and Juan Slowick. And of our departed sisters and brothers, Father, we pray for all of our deceased relatives and friends, and Pam Bradley and Nancy Slowick. And to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray that our Father at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace, guys.
Lamb of God, you take away the
Behold, this is Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, no worry that I should enter on my way. But only say the words.
The song for Holy Communion is Bread of Life, Hope of the World. The refrain is found on page 821 in the Gather. The choir will sing special Advent verses for today.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws even nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please find the closing song in Gather at number 318, number 318, People Look East.